Lesson 4, Principle of Ecology, Part 2. Hello learners, in our previous program of Principle of Ecology, Part 1, we have discussed about concept of ecology, different labels of ecological organizations, habitat and niche, concept of speciation and basic ideas about adaptation, evolution and extinction. I am Neelam Gupta, welcome you in this program of Environmental Science for Senior Secondary course of NIOS. Ecology will help us understand animals more. We can research the new species that are developing in different climates and different conditions. So, we can try to mock their behaviors. So, we can learn how to adapt to the changing environment as well. We can also research ways to help preserve our endangered wildlife, which will be beneficial to us. Now, we will discuss about the other concept of this lesson, that is population, community, structure, ecological succession and different types of interaction during this program. For this discussion, we have with us Dr. Aruna Mohan, retired associate professor, University of Delhi. She has long association with NIOS. Welcome to this program, madam.
Thank you, Neelam. Today's program's objectives are: explain the concept of population with reference to organisms, highlight the characteristics of size, growth, density and dispersion of population, analyze the demographic factors influencing the changes in population of organisms, explain community structure with reference to species, diversity, interspecific interactions and ecological succession. This slide shows population. On the left side, you can see individual, one organism, and the same population, you can see so many, the same organism. Population is defined as a group of freely interbreeding individuals of the same species present in a specific area at a given time. For example, when we say that the population of a city is 50,000, we mean that there are 50,000 humans in that city. However, all populations of humans living in any part of the world constitute the species Homo sapiens. A population has traits of its own which are different from those of the individuals forming the population. An individual is born and dies, but a population continues. It may change in size depending on birth and death rates of the population. An individual is either female or male, young or old, but a population has a sex ratio and age structure, which means the ratio of male to female in the population and the various age groups in which the population may be divided. Coming to characteristics of population, the characteristics of any population depends on density of the population, natality, that is birth rate, mortality, that is death rate, and dispersal. Also, biotic potential, age distribution, dispersion, and growth form. Coming to density, the number of individuals per unit area at a given time is termed as population density. It varies from time to time and also place to place. Example, more plants and insects can be seen during monsoon in the garden. It is measured by taking random samples from a measured area of a particular dimension. This is called quadrate. From that region for animals like tiger, lion, deer, etc. The pug marks are more useful to determine the actual number of such animals. Each cat has unique and different pug mark. In this particular slide, you can see the animals and their pug marks. There are other methods for count of human populations called census. It is carried out every 10 years and each individual is physically counted. Coming to natality or birth rate, in slide you can see some animals. The rate at which new individuals are born and added to a population under given environmental conditions is called natality. Birth, hatching, germination, and vegetative propagation cause an increase in the number of individuals in a population. Next point is mortality or death rate. Loss of individuals from a population due to death under a given condition is called mortality. It is obtained by calculating the death rate in a population. In this slide, you can see so many dead organisms. Next point is dispersal. This refers to movement of individuals of a population of a region on a permanent basis is termed emigration, while immigration refers to movement of individuals into a new area, where dispersal includes both emigration and immigration of individuals. When it is out of population, both these movements affect the population of a region. The population of a region is affected by dispersal, and here in this slide you can see dispersal. Active migration is not impossible in plants through seeds, may be dispersed over long distances by wind, water, and animals. So we can say that density of any population basically depends upon four factors, that is natality, mortality, immigration, and emigration. Thus, density of a population D is equal to Na plus 1 minus Dr plus E, where D is equal to density, Na is natality, I is immigration, E is emigration, and Dr is dispersal. The movement of individuals of a population out of a region on a permanent basis is termed emigration, while immigration refers to the movement of individuals into a new area, where dispersal includes both emigration and immigration of individuals. The population of a region is affected by dispersal. Active migration is not possible in plants through seeds, may be dispersed over long distances by wind, water, and animals. Next is age distribution. The population may be broadly divided into three age groups: pre-reproductive group, comprising of juvenile individuals or children; reproductive group, consisting of individuals capable of reproduction; post-reproductive group, contains aged individuals who are incapable of reproduction. In this slide, you can see age distribution, age structure of populations. You can see pyramid shape growing, then next one is bell shape, which is stable, and third one is urn shape, that is decreasing. Next one is sex ratio. Sex ratio is an important aspect of population. It refers to the ratio between female and male individuals in a population. This slide shows population growth, 3 billion to 6 billion to 9 billion. Population have characteristic pattern of growth with time, depicted by growth curves. Two basic forms are identified, sigmoid and J exponential type. It is also called density independent curve. It is generally typical of a species which reproduces rapidly and are greatly affected by season, fluctuation of environmental factors such as light, temperature, rainfall, etc. This type of growth curve shows a rapidly increasing population density in as exponential progression when there is abundant supply of resources, and after reaching the peak, there is sudden decline due to environmental and other factors. For example, insects which show explosive growth during the monsoon and then abruptly disappear at the end of the season. Similarly, forest fires, drought, floods, storms, etc. may reduce a population drastically. On the other hand, most of the organisms show S-shaped curve, where resources are limited, except the next level of organization that we take up, communities and their characters. So next topic is community. You can see a slide where community is shown. different kind of animals, different kind of organisms are shown in this particular slide. Community or biotic community refers to the populations of different kinds of organisms living together and share the same habitat. The characteristic pattern of the community is termed as the structure of the community and is determined by the role played by its various populations, the range of its various populations, the type of area that is inhabited by the populations of the community, the diversity of species in the community. In this particular slide, you can see community diversity, different kind of organism in the same area. The interactions between various populations of the community inhabiting the area. Members of a community also actively interact with their environment. In a community, only those plants and animals survive which are adapted to a particular environment. The climate determines the type of environment, hence the type of organisms in a community. For example, it is the climate of the area which determines whether a given area becomes a desert or a forest. The different kinds of organisms present in a community represent its species diversity. The species composition or diversity differs from one community to another. Even in the same community, there may be seasonal variation in species composition. Communities. We continue with the discussion. Communities created by human, such as lawns or crop communities, are such man-made communities. Our crop communities are relatively simple and consist of only one species, as opposed to a natural community characterized by a large number of species. Man-made communities are very unstable and require great deal of care and constant manipulations and maintenance. Stratification. Stratification of a community refers to the vertical layers of the vegetation. Tropical forests represent a good example of vertical stratification. In moist tropical rainforests, up to 5 distinct strata or layers of vegetation can be formed. These include from the forest floor to the top, ground layer of mosses and liverworts associated with dead leaves and other substances rich in organic matter. This will form the bottom layer. Herb or grass layer, this is the lower layer. The community stratification. You can see different strata. Then short shrub layer, tall shrub layer, layers of understory of short trees, this will make the middle layer. Then layer of canopy of lower trees and overstory or emergent tree layers formed by tall trees, this will make the upper layer. As in tropical forest, canopy dominates the area. And why canopy dominates the area? They modify the light and moisture for the shorter trees growing under them, which in turn determine the conditions for the ground vegetation. The vertical stratification of the plant community determines the structure of the community. Different layers are occupied by different species of plants and animals. Plants and animals of each layers differ in size, behavior, and adaptation from those of the other layers. To minimize the competition and conflict among the members of the community, stratification is a practical strategy to minimize the inter-specific competition. Community characteristics, species diversity. An important attribute of a community is its species diversity. The different kinds of organisms present in a community represent its species diversity. The species composition or diversity differs from one community to another. Even in the same community, there may be seasonal variations in species composition. Species diversity influences the stability of a community, can return to its original condition after being disturbed in some way. The diversity is calculated both by the number of species, that is richness, and the relative abundance of each species, that is evenness. Relative abundance is measure of a relative proportion of different species occurring in a community. The greater the number of species and more even their distribution, the greater is the species diversity. Now, another important topic, ecological succession. Biotic communities are dynamic in nature and change over a period of time. The process by which communities of plant and animal species in an area are replaced or changed into another over a period of time is known as ecological succession. Both the biotic and abiotic components are involved in this change. This change is brought about both by the activities of the communities as well as by the physical environment in that particular area. You can see in this slide the ecological succession, the primary succession and also the secondary succession. Ecological succession. The physical environment often influences the nature, direction, rate, and optimal limit of changes. During succession, both the plant and animal communities undergo change. There are two types of successions, primary succession and secondary succession. Primary succession. Primary succession takes place over a bare or unoccupied areas such as rocks, outcrop, newly formed deltas and sand dunes, emerging volcanoes, islands, as well as glacial moraines, muddy areas exposed by retreating glaciers, where no community has existed previously. The plants that invade first bare land, where soil is initially absent, are called pioneer species. The assemblage of pioneer plants is collectively called pioneer community. A pioneer species generally show high growth rate but short lifespan. Primary succession is much more difficult to observe than secondary succession because there are relatively very few places on earth that do not already have communities of organisms. Furthermore, primary succession takes place a very long time as compared to secondary succession, as the soil is to be formed during primary succession, while secondary succession starts in an area where soil is already formed or already present. Pioneer community. The community that initially inhabits a bare area is called pioneer community. The pioneer community after some time gets replaced by another community with different species combination. This second community gets replaced by a third community. This process continues sequence wise, in which a community replaced previously existing by another community. And the important terms, seral and climax community. Each transitional, that is temporary community that is formed and replaced during succession is called a stage in succession or a seral community. The terminal or the final stage of succession forms the community which is called a climax community. A climax community is stable, mature, more complex and long-lasting. The entire sequence of communities in a given area succeeding each other during the course of succession is termed serre. The animals of such a community also exhibit succession, which to a great extent is determined by plant succession. However, animals of such successional stages are also influenced by the types of animals that are able to migrate from neighboring communities. A climax community, as long as it is undisturbed, remains relatively stable in dynamic equilibrium with the prevailing climate and habitat factors. Succession that occurs on land where moisture content is low, for example on bare rock, is known as xerarch. Succession that takes place in a water body like ponds or lakes is called hydrarch. Coming to secondary succession. Secondary succession is the development of a community which forms after the existing natural vegetation that constitutes a community is removed, disturbed, or destroyed by a natural event like hurricane or forest fire, or by human-related events like tilling or harvesting land. Secondary succession. You can see in this slide the specific interactions. You can see a species interaction. It may be positive, it may be negative. If it is positive, then proto-cooperation, commensalism, mutualism, or it can be natural. If it is negative, it can be emmensalism, parasitism, predation, competition. Emmensalism. Emmensalism is a relationship in which a chemical compound produced by one organism as part of its normal metabolism has a negative effect on growth or survival of another organism when it comes in its contact. Mutualism. Nodules formed by rhizobium bacteria on the roots of several legume species. When nodules are present, legumes can fix nitrogen from the air, satisfying their own nitrogen nutrition requirements and providing excess nitrogen to non-legume plant species. Parasitism. You can see a slide for parasitism. Parasites. Nematodes or roundworms are incredibly common animals. Many are parasites and live in the intestines of other animals such as birds and mammals. One species inhabits the gut of the sperm whale. Many are serious parasites to humans, such as the Wuchereria bancrofti, which causes elephantiasis. You can see predation. Organism is trying to overpower the other one. In predation, in an ecosystem, predation is a biological interaction where a predator, an organism that is hunting, feeds on its prey, the organism that is attacked. The act of predation often results in the death of the prey and the eventual absorption of the prey's tissues through consumption. This slide shows competition. Two animals are fighting with each other for some competition. Competition occurs when two populations or species both need a vital resource that is in short supply. The vital resource could be food, water, shelter, nesting site, mates, or space. Such competitions can be interspecific and intraspecific. Intraspecific competition is interaction in population ecology whereby members of the same species compete for limited resources. This leads to a reduction in fitness for both individuals. By contrast, interspecific competition occurs when members of different species compete for a shared resource. Members of the same species have very similar resources requirements, whereas different species have a less resource overlap, resulting in a stronger intraspecific competition force than interspecific competition. In this particular slide, example of commensalism is shown. Commensals for food. A remora and its host, a zebra shark. Shark and sucker fish. Sharks are larger in size and sucker fish attaches itself to shark and feeds on the leftover food of shark. Presence of a sucker is an adaptation of remora. Here you can see in the slide the example of mutualism. Mutualism is relationship between two or more species where both the species derive a mutual benefit in terms of increasing their carrying capacity. Good example for this is lichen.
Thank you, ma'am. Dr. Arna Mohan discussed detail about the all concepts related to principles of ecology as mentioned earlier. Before we wrap up, we would like to recap the main points, that is what you have learnt. Population is a group of interbreeding and individuals found in a specific time in a particular geographical area. The characteristics of a population became evident through the population density, birth rate or natality, death rate or mortality, dispersion, immigration and migration, age distribution and sex ratio. Ecological succession is the successive growth of primary succession occurs in an area where there is no previous community. Secondary succession forms on existing natural vegetation. Biotic interaction refers to the interaction taking place between individuals belonging to the same species, that is intraspecific, or different species, that is interspecific. Examples are competition, predation, parasitism, symbiosis, commensalism and nutrism for interactions. So, this is all about population, population growth, communities, ecological succession and biotic interaction of lesson 4, principles of ecology. Thank you.